Welcome to Sathya Technologies. My screen is okay to you. My audio is okay. Please check and give your valuable feedback. My screen and audio, everything is okay. Okay, thank you, Dattatreya Shivanagaraju. Thank you very much for your Narayana. Mr. Narayana, sir. Screen is not visible to you. Check once again. So everybody is giving good response. Screen is okay and audio is okay. Let us start the session, sir. Once again, good morning to all of you. Welcome to Sathya Technologies. You are learning Hadoop course. I am CC Reddy. So this course is offered by Sathya Technologies, which is number one IT training institute in the world. Now, let us start the session. So yesterday, we have been discussing daemons of Hadoop. So how many daemons, sir? Five daemons. Name node, secondary name node, data node, job tracker, and task tracker. These are the five daemons of entire Hadoop framework. Okay, sir. Let us see the diagrammatic representation of this Hadoop daemons. What we are going to see, sir? Diagrammatic representation of these five daemons of the Hadoop. Observe the screen, sir. Observe the screen, sir. So here, daemons are represented in a diagrammatic format. Observe the layers also, sir. Here, I am drawing one more layer, okay, that is secondary name node. Here I am writing that daemon name, that is secondary name node, secondary name node. So it is just a standby. It's like assistant to name node, sir. So let us see the components here. First and foremost component is Hadoop name node. What is the first and foremost component, sir? Hadoop name node. So this Hadoop name node contains two parts, sir. Two parts, or otherwise you can say two components. Job tracker is related to MapReduce. Fundamental point, sir. Job tracker is related to MapReduce layer. If interviewer asks, job tracker related to HDFS or MapReduce, then your answer should be job tracker is related to MapReduce component, MapReduce layer. Similarly, this name node is related to HDFS layer. Name node is related to HDFS layer. Okay, so this secondary name node is like assistant to name node. Assistant to name node. But most of the cases, name node is acting very, very important role. Very, very important role. Now, when you come to another daemon called data node, this data node is another daemon. Okay, sir. So, under this data node, task tracker is running. What is running, sir? Task tracker is running. Task tracker is related to map reduce layer. Is related to map reduce layer. So, data node is related to HDFS layer. Task tracker is related to map reduce layer. This is fundamental points, sir. Five daemons of Hadoop. Okay. Five daemons of Hadoop. I am repeating once again, sir. Name node. What is that? Name node related to HDFS. Secondary name node related to HDFS and MapReduce. And next one is data node related to HDFS. Task tracker related to MapReduce. So totally five daemons of Hadoop. That's why in this diagram, I clearly mentioned what component comes under what category. For example, job tracker come under MapReduce category. Name node comes under HDFS category. Task tracker comes under MapReduce category. Data node comes under HDFS category. Like this, I clearly mentioned the layer names at the side of the boxes. So try to remember this diagram, sir. Okay, sir. Now, next topic we are going to see. Next we are going to see a new topic, that is, how does Hadoop works? How does Hadoop works? Whatever the theoretical points we are discussing daily, please don't forget them, sir, because all these theoretical points we are going to see practically. So at the time of practical sessions, these terms and terminologies we regularly refer. Name node, secondary name node, data node, job tracker, task tracker. Like this, these terms we use daily, regularly. So don't forget whatever theoretical points up to this moment. Okay. Now, next topic is, how does Hadoop work? How does Hadoop work? This is the next topic. Try to concentrate on this topic, sir. In multiple interviews, this question is asked, how does Hadoop work? What are the different stages involved into this Hadoop? Like this, interviewer will ask the questions. I am writing stage one, sir. Stage one. In stage one, what happens? In stage one, what happens? Observe the screen, sir. This daily notes is available at support@sathyatech.com. Try to notice this point, sir. This diary notes is available at support@sathyatech.com. Observe the screen and watch every point, sir. So how does Hadoop work? So in stage one, how it is behaving, how it is working? In stage one, a user or an application, user or an application can submit a job to the Hadoop. To the Hadoop means, I am writing its meaning. A Hadoop job client, that is the meaning. Hadoop job client, that means a user or an application submits its job to Hadoop job client. That is the meaning. For what purpose it is submitting? For required process by specifying the following items. What items they are specifying? What aspects they are specifying? Are you observing, sir? So in stage one, firstly, what happens, sir? An user or an application submits a job to a Hadoop job client. For what purpose? For required process purpose. What they are specifying? The following items they are going to specify. What is the first item? What is the first item? First item is the location of the input and output files. Where? In the distributed file system. In the distributed file system, that is DFS. And clearly to specify HDFS. So what is the first aspect, sir? First item, user submits the job to the Hadoop job client for required process by specifying the first item. That is, what is the first item, sir? The location of input and output files in the distributed file system. That is the first item. And second, what is the second item user or application gives? Second item is the Java classes. What is that, sir? The Java classes in the form of jar file. What jar stands for, sir? Java RQ file. Some people will pronounce Java RQ file also. What is jar, sir? It's a collection of classes, interfaces, and specified packages. That is called jar. So, second item is the Java classes in the form of jar file containing the implementation of map and reduce functions. See the second aspect once again, sir. The user use second item as the Java classes in the form of jar file containing the implementation of map and reduce functions. That is the second item. Okay, sir. Now, third item. We are seeing three items of stage one, sir. All these three items are given in stage one. Okay, sir. In stage one, these three items or aspects will be given. Who will give? A user, Hadoop user or Hadoop application will give these three aspects or items. Okay, sir. Third item I am writing. Observe the screen. The job configuration by setting different parameters specific to the job. Job configuration. What are the specifications of the job? Those particular specifications are given in the form of different parameters. Observe the point, sir. The job configuration by specifying different parameters which are specific to the job. These parameters will be passed in stage one. So don't forget these things, sir. While we are executing map reduce, these three items are very, very important. Okay, sir, don't forget these stages. Just now we have seen stage one. In stage one, three aspects we have seen. Don't forget these things. We are all Hadoop users. As Hadoop user in stage one, we particularly give these three items. That's why don't forget them. Now I am writing stage two. Observe the screen, sir. Stage two. So under stage two, what things to be considered? First, the Hadoop job. Observe the screen, sir. The Hadoop job client. Then submits the job. The job means what, sir? jar file or some executables, etc. Some executables. He may give jar file or any other exe file also. Jar file or executable file. And configuration. And configuration on the job tracker. On the job tracker. Observe, sir. Under stage 2, first step is what, sir? The Hadoop job client. What is that, sir? The Hadoop job client. We are all what, sir? Hadoop users or Hadoop job clients. What we submit, sir? Job. What is about job, sir? Technically to speak, job is nothing but jar file. Job is nothing but jar file. Along with means you can pass jar file or some executable file. Some executable file. And what also we are passing, sir? And configuration. Configuration. This configuration is related to HDFS configuration. What is HDFS configuration, sir? What is a file name? What is the block size? How many replications? Where those replicated blocks are stored? In which data nodes they are stored? Like this. All these details are stored into configuration. That configuration details, jar file, or you can pass executable file in the first step of stage 2. Okay. On what you are passing, sir? On job tracker. On what, sir? On job tracker, you are submitting all these things. Tell me, sir, once again, what and what are submitting? Submitting jar file, or you can pass executable file. Along with that, configuration details. Tell me, what are the configuration details, sir? Configuration details are nothing but HDFS configuration details. What are the HDFS configuration details, sir? Block size. Okay. How many replications? Where those replication blocks are stored? Like that. All these details are existed in configuration aspect. That is the first step of the stage 2. Now, I am writing second step of the stage 2. I am writing the second step of the stage 2. Please observe the screen. Second step is job tracker. Then performs the following responsibilities. The following responsibilities. So whenever you submitted jar, what, sir? Whenever you submitted jar file or executable file, along with that configuration details to job tracker, then what job tracker will do? Job tracker will perform the following responsibilities. Now I'm writing those responsibilities one by one, sir. Please observe the screen. I'm writing those responsibilities one by one. First and foremost responsibility is done by job tracker is, I'm writing, sir, distributing the software or configuration to the slaves. What are the slaves, sir? Data nodes are the slaves. So what it is giving, sir? Job tracker is doing first and foremost responsibility as distributing the software. Suppose to perform the particular task, some additional softwares will be required, sir. That additional softwares will be automatically provided by the job tracker. So data node need not worry about the required software and configuration, because required software and required configuration are passed by whom? Job tracker provides all sufficient aspects to the slaves. What are the slaves, sir? Data nodes. Now I am writing second responsibility of the job tracker, sir. I am writing second responsibility of the job tracker. What is the second responsibility by the job tracker? Scheduling. Observe the screen, sir. Scheduling tasks and monitoring them. That is the second responsibility, sir. So what job tracker is doing? Job tracker is scheduling the task and monitoring the tasks. Okay, it prepares one schedule. Task 1, task 2, task 3, like this. It prepares list of tasks and schedule of them. And finally, monitoring them. Are they working properly or not? If any problem is arised, how to solve? All this monitoring is done by the job tracker, sir. Now, I am writing the third responsibility. What is that, sir? Third responsibility of the job tracker. Observe the screen, sir. I am writing third responsibility. Observe the screen, sir. Observe the screen. I am writing third responsibility under stage 2. Now I am writing third responsibility of the job tracker, sir. Observe the screen. Third responsibility. Providing. What is that, sir? Providing status and diagnostic information to the job client. So what is the third responsibility, sir? Providing status. What status, sir? Task status. Okay, how much task is completed? What results are obtained? for that task. And next one is what, sir? Diagnostic information. Diagnostic means evaluation, sir. That means task is correct or not. Does it has produced correct results or not? Like this, results are diagnotized. Diagnotized means evaluated. So that information is provided to job client. Who will provide, sir? Job tracker is doing all these responsibilities. Okay, Okay, sir. So these are the three responsibilities. Which are provided by job tracker. This is stage two, sir. Up to this, we have completed stage one and stage two. Okay, of which topic, sir? How does Hadoop work? Under that topic, we have finished stage one, stage two. Now we are going to touch the stage three. How Hadoop works in stage three. Observe the screen, sir. Stage three. How it works in stage three. So in stage three, the task trackers. What, sir? The task trackers on different nodes execute the task as per MapReduce implementation. So under stage three, what happens, sir? Observe the screen. The task trackers on different nodes. What nodes, sir? Data nodes. Because in each data node, which component is running, sir? Task tracker is running. So task trackers on different data nodes execute the task as per MapReduce implementation. Whatever the program we have given in MapReduce, according to that, task will be executed. That's why in further sessions, we are going to write MapReduce programs. According to those MapReduce programs, these task trackers will perform the execution. That happens in stage three, sir. Now, second point of stage three, I am writing, sir. Second step of stage three, I am writing. Observe the screen, sir. Sir, once a task is over, what will be coming, sir? Output. So, output of the reduce function is stored into the output files, into the output files on the file system, on the file system. So once the task is over, what happens, sir? We get output. So output of reduce function. Okay, output of reduce function is stored into output files. How many functions are there, sir? Map function, reduce function. What is the final function, sir? Reduce function. Once reduce function is executed, then final output comes. That final output is stored into output files. Where those output files are stored, sir? Those output files are stored on file system. What file system we are using in Hadoop, sir? HDFS. Stands for what, sir? Hadoop Distributed File System. In that HDFS, these output files will be stored. So this is the entire work, sir. So how does Hadoop works? These are the three stages, sir. Very, very important interview question. Are you understanding, sir? In multiple interviews, this question is asked. How does Hadoop works? What is the working style of Hadoop? Then what answer you have to say, sir? Hadoop works in three stages. Stage one, stage two, stage three. In stage one, what happens? Here I clearly mentioned, sir. Already you have seen. Observe the screen, sir. So in stage one, these three aspects will be done. In stage two, these three aspects will be done. In stage three, these two aspects will be done. Okay, sir. Try to remember all these points, sir. Try to remember. Because this is the basement, sir. This is what? Basement. You are learning total Hadoop course. In that, how Hadoop is working, you should know, sir. That's very important. So Hadoop works in three stages. These are the three stages. In first stage, what happens, sir? A user or application, okay, submits the job. Okay, submits the job. To whom, sir? To Hadoop job client. With what parameters, sir? With these three parameters. In stage two, what happens, sir? In stage two. In stage two, Hadoop job client submits the job in the form of jar file or executable file. Along with this, configuration is also submitted. To whom, sir? Job tracker. Then what job tracker will do, sir? I have written now, sir. These three responsibilities are done by job tracker. Once these three responsibilities are done by job tracker, immediately task tracker will start the execution of the tasks. That's why they are called task tracker. task tracker means which executes the tasks. They are also called as task executors. What is job tracker, sir? Job tracker provides the jobs to task trackers. That's why it is called as job tracker. Why it is called job tracker, sir? Job tracker provides the jobs to the task trackers. What is task tracker, sir? Task tracker executes the tasks. That's why they are called task trackers. Okay. What they are executing, sir? They are executing MapReduce programs. Task trackers are executing what, sir? Task trackers are executing MapReduce programs. Once MapReduce programs are executed, output will come, sir. Output will come. That output is stored into file system. What file system, sir? HDFS. Stands for Hadoop Distributed File System. So these are the three important stages in Hadoop work. Okay, sir. So this notes is available at support@sathyatech.com. Okay, sir. Go through the notes, whatever the theoretical aspects we have discussed up to this class. Please try to read them daily, sir, because these are all basics of Hadoop. Without knowing these basics, you can't understand the implementation, sir. That's why these basics are very, very important. These basics are very, very helpful for executing the tasks in Hadoop. That's why don't forget them. Thank you very much, sir, for joining today for Hadoop class, which is offered by Sathyatechnologies. It is number one IT training institute in the world. Thank you very much. Once again, good day wishes to all. Thank you.